Cosplay World, we're answering the cosplay question of the week. Yes. Maybe I should call it. It's hard to get this out on Monday sometimes because of conventions, and I'm like, I have con plague, and sorry, I know I have questions for people to answer, and I didn't answer them on Monday. I'm a terrible person, but I will answer them. Yes, I'm getting to them. Okay, first and foremost, I'm going to go over a question of how do I attach like a scythe head to a prop. I'm going to go over in general terms, because you can have a big old hammer head, or it can have a blade, or any kind of attachment to a pipe, just to cover a few bases here. Now what we have here is some basic PVC pipe. I don't like to use dowels. They splinter, and they don't hold screws as well. Dowels themselves don't hold screws as well as PVC pipe. In my opinion, this is all opinionated here. Maybe some of the thicker, big chunks of beefy wood that cost a ton, maybe those hold screws real well, but PVC pipe does a pretty good job, and it's valuable. That's a pretty good advantage there. And the cat is walking in because it's being a cat. Okay, so what we want to do for say this is a blade, it's going to be like this, or it's an axe, or a pickaxe, yeah. We want to put a channel in there. Now, one way to do it is if you have a nice Dremel, is to carve yourself a nice channel in there, and actually, I'll do it, yeah, it's cool, it's right. I'm gonna wear a mask because their stuff is gonna fly everywhere, and this is my, riot mask. It's really awesome when you're dealing with like I said, when you're dealing with molten plastic, that stuff hurts. And even in goggles and safety glasses, that stuff will get in there, and it's really a ton of pain. So there, a little notch. And you can stick you can't really stick this piece in there, but you can imagine just sticking a piece of wood into that little slot there and putting some screws in. Simple as that. Let me see, screws. There's the screws. Okay. Like to keep everything close to hand. My cosplay room isn't really in order yet. It's getting there. We have a lot of fabric to put away, which is kind of holding things up. And then we're gonna move on to awesome things we built. But wait, losing focus. Focus here, focus. Anyway, use this technique to make this this prop here. You can see that there's nothing on this side. It's perfectly fine. Just kind of dug out a channel and then stuck it in and glued it in there. So, that's how that's done. But on a lot of my videos, you see me doing this, it's actually two parts. Now, if you don't have a heat gun, you can go in with a file. You can start yourself a notch. And what this notch is for is to keep you from cutting yourself. Okay? So you use that notch and you come in and you cut that. Okay? There we go. Simple enough. Now, I have a heat gun. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to heat it up and get it nice and soft. There's lots of ways to get this stuff done. So, awesome. You can always cap it off. I cap that one off with a bit of friendly plastic, but you can cap it off with any kind of decorative bits. This is especially useful when you have something to cover it up with, because I think it, of what we're about to do, it gives a little bit stronger hold. Okay, so there we go. That was pretty easy because the plastic's nice and soft. Missy, is this nice and warm? Yeah, it's nice and warm. So that plastic's gonna be easy to cut too. So what we got here is a little channel, and I'm gonna heat this up. Now, what you could do is carve out a channel on both sides if you don't have a Dremel. This stuff can be pretty hard if you don't have tools. I didn't get all these tools right away. I collected them over the years, so I mean, I don't know. I don't know. Maybe not all of these are useful to everyone. But most people should have a saw and a file and things like that.
just basic hand tool.
So what I'm doing is I'm softening these up. Yes, cat is meowing. Stop messing up my audio, you terrible cat. Rawr.
Okay.
So there we go. Now, I don't really want to get into this piece of wood because it's still brand new. It's not really used. But this piece of plastic is like $1's worth, so I'm not going to worry about that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to press it. It's hot. And trust me, it's pretty hot. And it's going to form this kind of groove that holds it in place. And bam. If it's a scythe, you can kind of mount it like this. It's an axe or a hammer. Or if it's like an axe. But these are for bladed items. If it's like a lance, you can mount it just like this. And you can put several screws in there. If you want it to be more secure in, you just mount it deeper in. And then, of course, you can kind of carve this into decorative shapes if it's necessary. You know, there we go. But there's our channel. That's kind of what we're going for here. Now, for things that you can't really... we'll say hammers or things like that that are round. Like, say we wanted to attach it to, like, this tube here for a hammer. I have a different trick for that. Okay? So, if it's a small hammer, you may only need two. But if it's a big hammer, what I do is I split it into three. Also, if it's a big hammer, I use a bigger piece of plastic. This is the smallest. This is 1/2 inch. Okay, it's not the smallest, but it's the most common smallest piece. So I'll cut a hole in here and then stick it on the inside. And then I'll put the screws in and attach it in place. And there we go. That's our hammer. Pretty straightforward. Okay. So that's that. How about, you know, I'm gonna cut this just to show. You see me do, yeah, I think you will see, no, you have seen me, you have, in the, steampunk, in my, my wings, my steampunk cannon, winged cannon, I did this trick with the handle. And this is it, this is a good place, just generally a good thing to do with pipe. And you can reform it, it goes right back. As long as you don't burn it, it's not too terrible. Okay, there we go. There we go. Okay. There we are. And then we have this nice kind of flowery shape bit. And... voila! Mount that to the inside, and yeah, you just drill a hole and then mount it to the inside, and you can put screws in, and it'll hold it really well. If it's wood or if it's like a cardboard tube, a really heavy cardboard tube, not just a flimsy one, you can probably heat it up and fit it better. But yeah, that's what you're gonna do. Pretty straightforward. You can mount it. Two pieces like so for sometimes I have to join them to wood, and this is how I'll do it. Is I'll put screws in each one of the legs. What did I do this for? I did this for my Sin. Final Fantasy X, any of you familiar? I made a Sin cosplay. It was like as big as a cab. It was pretty cool. Oh well. Alright. Next question is PVC. What is PVC? People ask me what PVC is. I think I refer to it too casually, like it's common knowledge, but this is PVC. It's also called some brand name, I forget the name. But cilia, no. I forget exactly what. This is PVC, polyvinyl chloride plastic. I have several other kinds of plastic, but this is what you'll see me use most commonly. It comes in several colors. White, black. I have some red near me. No, I don't have reds over there. So I got a bunch. Oh, there's blue over there too, and gray. No gray here. Oh, well. But this is pretty usable, or pretty useful as a cosplay material. It's very, very malleable. ABS in the thinner sheets is pretty good, but when you get to the ABS in the thicker sheets, it gets to be pretty hard to work with. It's very, very strong stuff. And of course they asked me, where can I find this? Well, of course you can check online. All you have to do is search for PVC or plastic sheets. And there's a number of online stores that would deliver. I wish I could give you prices because that would be nice, but unfortunately, plastic is petroleum based. So what this means is, as the price in gas varies, so does the price in plastic. So yes, plastics are made from oil, basically. Or at least most of it is, or gravity, yeah. Okay. Anyway, luckily plastics are recyclable, so recycle your plastics so we can keep the price down on the stuff. Oh well. You can also find it in local stores. PVC. Sign places sometimes have it. I found it in places that make signs. You can also find local plastic sellers. If you look in your phone book, that's how I found my first. Okay, that's where I found my second plastic dealer, is going through the phone book. My first plastics dealer was across the street from my house, so I mean, it wasn't too hard to look. Came in, asked for some plastic and gave me some samples. It was pretty cool. But he was pretty expensive, though, because he's used to working with larger volume base. Oh well. I don't know. I think that's it. I guess I could show off my. I got this from my house finally when we were moving, so I have a new place. And this is my really, really nice heat gun. This baby goes up to 1350 degrees, and if the low setting is 250 degrees and it has a cool cycle, that's pretty awesome. This one has lasted me 6 or 7 of these little things. These little things will burn out they'll burn out more easily than this good one. This one, they always come with nozzles and things like that, but this is much more durable. This is about $20-$25. This is about $50. I mean, just after the second time I got, it's totally worth it. If you can invest in getting a better one, or if when you buy it, you do get this good one, that's the way to go. $50 around about Wagner, totally better than, what is this, Tool Shop? No, this is Wagner too, I guess they're both Wagner. Okay, well, that would explain why this one's lasted a little longer than the rest. Wagner's a good brand for heat guns, if you ask me. Let me see. And I think that's it. I'm gonna end this rant. Please send me your questions and things like that so I can be more engaged with you all. I like to talk to people, not be all, I spend a lot of time here kind of in this room, so like socializing is weird. Oh my god, I'm such a freak, I can't believe this. I'm ending this video. See you guys.